kids and jam friends. Remember last week we talked about God's creations and how we can see God, what God is like through his creation? Well, when God made the world, it was perfect. Animals didn't fight and kill each other. There was no sickness or disasters. Everything worked in perfect order. Is that the world we see today? Unfortunately, it's not. Animals now fight and kill each other. Sometimes people fight and kill each other. People get sick and die. There are natural disasters like floods, tornadoes, and fires. Countries fight wars. And so what happened to God's perfect creation? You know, when Adam and Eve disobeyed God and sinned, the world was no longer perfect and good. Sickness, sadness, and death came into the world. Eventually, people began to forget about God, even though they could see the amazing world he created. Some people even began to say that the world wasn't created by God, but it just happened, like the Big Bang Theory. But because God is amazing and all-powerful, he has a plan to bring creation back to being right again, to being perfect. In fact, his plan to do this started right after Adam and Eve sinned against him. God promised to send a savior so people would not have to be separated from him. The savior is Jesus, God's perfect son. Jesus came to earth, which is infected with sin. He didn't have to. He could have stayed up in heaven, his home, where everything is perfect and right all the time. But Jesus chose to become a human baby and leave perfect heaven and come down to imperfect earth. Jesus is a savior who came so you would no longer be separated from God. That was the first part of God's making his creation right again. Because sin affects creation, bad things happen in the world. Wars, famine, diseases, and disasters. People's sin also causes bad things to happen. God has a plan for all of that too. The Bible says creation is groaning, waiting for God to make things right. And someday he will. God's plan is that one day he will make a new earth, an earth that is not hurt by sin. It will be perfect, just like it was when God first made the world. Just like Jesus' work on the cross can make people new, one day God will make a new perfect heaven and earth where there will be no sin, sadness, or death. We don't know when God will do this, but he still will. We gotta trust, and because God promised and he always keeps his promises. But who will live on this new earth and enjoy it? The people who will enjoy the new earth are those who have trusted Jesus to save them from sin. They will enjoy creation as God made it in the very beginning. In fact, it will be even better. What a wonderful thing to look forward to. If you believe on Jesus as your savior, you can worship God when you see his creation. How will you respond when you see the wonders and details of all he has created? Well, let's look in Psalm 95:6. Come, let us bow down and worship. Let us kneel before the Lord, our maker. When we realize how great God is in all of his amazing creation, it makes us want to worship him, to say how great he is. We are saying, God, you did a great job and we appreciate all that you did. You are great. You can also sing songs of praise to God. You can draw a picture of something in creation that you want to thank God for. You can tell others about how great God is. When you see something beautiful in creation, you can say, God, you are great.